Yoohoo! Hello guys, welcome to my channel. In this channel, you will learn about money management, support and resistance, and other amazing stuff that you will need to know. Yes, you need to know this in order to become a profitable trader. So guys, still I have seen this quote and it's very true. Trading is a game of probability. If you don't have to be right, you don't have to win every trade. So you just need to follow some rules, some simple rules that I have made video on this in this channel. So you need to watch this channel. You need to have a trading plan. You need to have a money management. You need to know if the market is it good to trade. You need to know if there is news in the market, and you need to know why this candle behaves like this, how it behaves. And don't use indicator, because indicator is not a 100% 100% winning ratio. No, it is not at least 80%. So you will have less chance to win with indicator. I will make a video on this. Comment below and like the video. Hit the subscribe button, guys. I have already 18 subscribers. I'm very happy. So guys, subscribe, and I am very thank you for watching this video, and thank you subscriber for subscribing. So you need to have a trading plan, a set of plan. You need to focus that you will lose. You will lose, okay? You will lose, but you need to have a plan to know how you can cope, how you can cope the losses. I'm trying to find the word. Okay, so today I will show you how you can trade with inverted hammer. This is not a shooting stop, this is an inverted hammer. So an inverted hammer, sometimes it acts as a reverse sign in forex, but in binary it sometimes continues the market and it sometimes reverse the market. So we will see how it operates and how it behaves. So an inverted hammer can also be a bearish or be bullish, but I'm talking about this. So you need a bullish inverted hammer, okay, in order to trade. So the body need to be small, okay? You need to have a small body, and you need to have a higher wick. The wick should be longer, 2 times the body, which show either it is a selling pressure or a buying pressure, okay? In this video, I will show you how you can trade with it. So the first thing you need to do is you need to check. You need to know if the hammer have 2 times the wick and a small body. This is the first thing. Identify if it is a hammer or not. So you see it is a hammer. So what you need to do is you see what is it behave. So if you do it 5 minutes, you will have more time, okay? If you do in 1 minute, you need to be faster, okay? So let's see. The first thing you need to know, if you need to go on in the past, first thing you need to know where is the buyers and sellers. If in the past there is a strong buyers area, a strong momentum on this area, so this is a reversal sign and the market will reverse. So this is a reversal sign. Oh, you need to check in the past level if there is a buyers area here. So this will reverse the market. The hammer shows that there is a strong buying pressure. You see, it made a new high. There is a strong buying pressure, and this shows that sellers have entered, but buyers are more powerful. It turned it into a bullish candle. You see, the buyers are so powerful that it made a new high. And what is a new high mean? It means that the resistance is now here. The resistance is now here and the sellers is here. Let me show you more clearly. The sellers is now here and there is no sellers in this area. So from this area to this area, buyers can enter. So this candle is a reversal sign. If you see, first you need to know, and if you see this candle, you first need to know your expectation. What is your expectation? What do you see when you're seeing this candle? Does the future price will go up or will go down? What you need to expect in the future, okay? As soon as you acquire the expectation, you wait for the confirmation. Then you take the trade. What is the confirmation? Yeah, the confirmation is very important because the confirmation will help to improve your winning ratio and will help you to make more sure trade, sure shot. The confirmation means that the rejection. This is a rejection. This is a confirmation. This is a rejection. Like I have shown you that the rejection need to be. Let me show you in 5 seconds. If you see the rejection, it will be like this. If you see in 5 seconds, the rejection will be like this. And you see, it is a bullish engulfing. This means that the buyers are more powerful than sellers, and the next candle will have the probability. There is no 100% in market, so it will mostly go up if you need a rejection. So I will show you where you will need the price will reject where. I will show you. Sorry for this. Okay, so yeah, it's good. Now it is clean. Now you can follow. You can do. Okay, so you need the price to reject here. You need a rejection here at this level. Let me show you with arrows. You will be more. You need the rejection here at the half of the hammer. You need the rejection here at the half of the hammer. Then you place your trade. You need it at the half. Let me show you in red. Here. Okay, here you need the rejection at the half. Then you place, it will be a share trade. So you have your expectation, you have your week, you place your trade. Now I will show you when to place your trade. You place your trade if there is a wrong number, okay? If there is a wrong number, you place your trade because it shows that the market is respecting the wrong number and buyer will likely to enter. So you need a strong level, okay? In the past, if there are buyers, you wait for a strong level. If it is there is a wrong number, it will be very, very good. You don't need to wear rejection if there is a wrong number. You just place your trade and I'm sure that the price will go the direction that you have predicted. You wait for a rejection. I have shown you that the rejection is here. You wait for a rejection. And if there is a weak SNL, which is 1-2 candle, you place your trade. It will be a winning trade because it made a new high. And this is a reversal sign at the level. Sorry, at the level. Okay. So what does it mean? What is the psychology, the pattern psychology? I will show you. I don't have many times to do this. The pattern psychology shows that the buyers have entered here. The buyers have entered here, right? This is the buyers have entered here. Let me show you. The buyers have entered here. So here the buyers have entered strongly with a strong force. It made a new high. A new high, which means that the seller reject here. At this level, the sellers reject. The seller reject at this level. Okay, buyers are entered strongly, and it made a new high. Sellers reject here. Sellers reject the price here. So, which means that there is a new resistance. The resistance is now up. Okay, and this shows the gap. There are some gaps to this level, and you see there are no sellers. Sellers are here. So you can place your trade here, and this is a level. This is a level, and if you see this level and buyers are very strong and you don't see any lower wick, if you see it, if you see there is a longer lower wick, this means that it is not a hammer, it can be a spinning top. So there is no a lower wick. I have 10 minutes, so I don't want to waste time. So if there is no lower wick, you can go with buyers. You can go with buy because there are some gaps. It made a new high, which means that the resistance is now here, and you wait the rejection for a. If you want it as a sure trade, it's better to wait a rejection. But if you see that it make a new high and there is a strong buying pressure and there is a wrong number here, so if there is a wrong number here, you can go with buyer because you know that buyers will enter. So you need to a raw number, or if you see a strong buying a strong level, and if either you have seen a strong buyers and seller, so it's better to go with the buyers. So you see here, It made a new high, and you see there is a love.